What's going on, everybody? It's your favorite dating coach, Elliot Scott. And as you can see by the title below and this big ass list of things, which we'll go over, we're going to talk about how to get a guy afraid of losing you. Not to get him back, but how to make him afraid of losing you. Something might be happening. He's taking you for granted, taking advantage of the situation that he has you. And again, maybe not even in a relationship, just dating, talking, moving forward, things like that. But again, he's taking you for granted. This is going to be the list of things to do. Now, if you haven't yet, please subscribe. Just click the red button below. It looks like this, not this way, it's that way, but it looks like that. Also, if you want to work with yours truly, there's a link in the description, phone session, email session, and if you want to get more information on this, I have a post on it on my website, which I will link down in the comments. Now, before we get started, I didn't talk about the bell notification. I wonder why I didn't talk about that. I'll tell you why. Because I actually got a bell that's louder. That's actually too loud. Louder than, Oh shit. Louder than my ex-girlfriend, so I don't know if I'll be using that a lot, but sounds like her too. So here's the thing. I have feeling gaps, common sense, and context. And I want to break these down first before I actually get into them. If you can't read this, that's fine. I'll list them out. However, feeling gaps is what is the term I'm using for this is, or the definition would be, things you're doing that's hinting to him that there's something up, right? Maybe there's another guy in the picture. Maybe you're not as interested. Something's up, right? A wrench is thrown in there. It's not too bad yet, but it's hinting at something. Common sense, I don't know why I called it that, but I'm going to call it that. It's just, well, it's called common sense because it's stuff that you're doing where he's thinking, okay, something's up. There's another guy in the picture. She's not caring as much. Something is different. And of course, context just kind of emphasizes that, right? It's just things you do that kind of build the context, fill in the gaps. Don't worry about that, but it fills in, it creates the vibe, right? So for example, I'm sure you all have heard of this before, but the guy who's always saying, I gotta work late. And then you find out he's having an affair or cheating on you. Then you look back at it, you're like, oh, that's why you always had to work late. That's those kind of things, okay? So let's jump right into this. The first thing is filling gaps. Now, the things I tell women to do here are being unpredictable, right? Guys like routine. Guys like, not just routine, but they like convenience. And I feel like when a woman's always there on, so I guess both these can go together, unpredictable and changing patterns. Guys like conditioning, guys like routine. He's going to go down the path of least resistance. If you're going to make it very easy for him to get a hold of you, talk to you, and you're going to be there at his beck and call, always available, too eager, too interested, too intense, then why would he invest his resources in you? He's going to go down the path of least resistance. He's not going to commit to you. He's not going to do whatever you want him to do if you're giving him the kitchen sink and everything else, okay? So you have to remain unpredictable, and you have to change the patterns up, because as soon as he starts getting comfortable, that's the way it's going to be for him. And when you start to change, people don't like change. He's going to fight it, okay? Obviously, the third bullet point is be mysterious. You got to be mysterious. You got to keep someone on their feet, okay? Be yourself. Now, when I say be yourself, that's not that McDonald's slogan, be yourself or whatever. Everyone has that slogan, you know, be the best you. You know, guys should only like you for you. You don't change for anyone else. That's not what I'm saying. This is more of a, you know, a carefree, which I have down here, which is, dude, I don't give a fuck, dude. I'm just going to do me. I'm going to better myself for me. And what I'm trying to say is you're not putting so much attention onto him, okay? So it's very important to be yourself. Also, pick up hobbies and go to the gym. Why is that? Guys know when a girl goes to the gym, she's trying to look good. There's other guys there. And at the same time, when a woman's becoming sexier and trying to better herself and she's looking better and bettering her figure, and the guy isn't, it's going to catch up to him where he's thinking, oh shit, she's going to leave me behind in the dust. Trust me, guys think that, okay? Right here, be carefree. Just like I said up here, you gotta be kind of be yourself. When you're carefree, you have a freedom of outcome, right? Which I talk about somewhere over here. You have a freedom of outcome. You don't care anymore. It's the fact that women care so much more than guys, which is why they always lose in this situation. Always lose. They care, which means they have a desire, which means they're looking for an outcome, which means they have something to lose, while a guy's playing it very carefree, as you know. Just flip the switch. If you watch a guy, he's kind of like, I don't give a shit, I'm going to come and go when I play. That's why he's always winning, okay? Take lead. When you take lead, it shows the guy that, it's like, I don't really need you, dude. Like, I got my own shit to, and this is all creating that vibe, right? Like I said, with context, but in a different way. He's filling in those gaps. He's starting to put things together. You know, why is she being unpredictable? Why is she changing? Why is she starting to go to the gym all of a sudden? Why is she not taking lead and not letting me take lead? Why is she becoming independent? Why is she becoming a strong asshole? You know, all that kind of stuff. Of course, improves sex. And there's only two ways to improve sex. Having sex and looking and kind of looking that stuff up, right? So if you're having the same sex with him and he's like, oh, she's getting better, well, why are you getting better? You know, I mean, I don't want him thinking that about you, but just plant a seed in his head. Confidence, nothing sexier than confidence, right? A woman who's confident all of a sudden and is not looking for that guy for validation kind of triggers something. His brain is thinking, well, why is she all confident all of a sudden? Why is she not caring about what I'm thinking? Why is she just doing her own thing? Again, plants the seed in the head. And of course, don't fight, because when you fight, you care, right? Now, I'm not saying you don't care, and I'm not saying be a bitch, right? And I'm not saying do all these things together, because you are going to look like a bitch, you are going to start some confrontation, and you are going to push him away, depending on which ones you do and how many of them you do it and for how long and the intensity you do it. So don't be a bitch about it. I'm just saying here's some things you can do to kind of level it out. So like I said, if you don't fight, you don't fight because you don't give a shit, okay? It's going to catch on to him. Now, common sense. This is the stuff, like I said, that it's like, okay, there's something up. Scarcity. If you're scarce and you're pulling away and you're just not seeking that validation, like I said right here, I don't give a fuck, in quotations, you don't give a shit. He's catching on. Competition. Other guys in the picture, okay? Especially if he's one of those guys who doesn't want to commit to you but still likes coming around and talking and things like that and having his cake and eat it too. If that's the case, or he says, I want to be exclusive but not together. Like, I only want to have sex with each other. I just can't get in a relationship right now. Nope. Start bringing the competition. Lock your phone. I don't need to explain that one. Going out with the girls a lot more, going to bars and clubs. I don't need to explain that one. Those two make a guy's mind wander, right? Or sorry, those two. Add a guy on social media. Who's this guy I'm adding on social media? Or who's this bitch adding on social media, right? He's probably thinking, oh, hell no. Gonna make him a little jealous. Then you, of course, just say, it's a friend, blah, 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 which I have down here. Bring up that guy friend, which is, now I'm sure women have done this before, and I'm sure guys have done this to you, or I'm sure you've seen it, where a girl or a guy starts talking about that girl at work who's just a friend, but then they end up getting together. You kind of want to plant that seed in his head. Pull away, kind of self-explanatory. Stop initiating, again, part of pulling away, kind of self-explanatory. Don't need to really explain those. Now, context, like I said, this kind of builds into this. It builds that vibe, okay? Stop investing your resources into the guy. Time, effort, money, energy, things like that. Stop investing that. As soon as you start investing those things, he knows he has you. There's nothing wrong with doing it, just as long as he does it too, okay? So if it's one-sided and you're feeling like you're investing a lot more than him, cut back, kind of, okay? Make him curious, kind of self-explanatory, which I'm saying that a lot because it is. Like I said, kind of the things over here, like being mysterious. You want to keep him on his feet. If you're always, like I said, if you're always investing your resources, if you're not creating competition, if you're not being scarce and you're always there on his beck, you know, you're not changing up the patterns, you're not becoming unpredictable, and you're just always there on his beck and call, then I don't see why he's going to change or why he's going to commit. He's having the best of both worlds. I know so many women who will stick around for a guy and hopes things change. So she lowers her value, and then she wonders why the guy doesn't commit. Why would he? He has the best of both worlds. He's literally having everything he wants with you because you don't have a backbone to walk away. So he's just going to go talk to these other girls because he is still technically single. Huh? It happens all the time. So smile at others. I usually mean smile at other guys. Kind of flirting is what I mean by that. Stop reacting. Same thing with reacting as I have with don't fight. When you react, it means two things. It means you care, and it means you care about the outcome, right? Like, when you only react, for example, you only react of jealousy when a guy's talking to another girl because you like the guy, right? So if you don't react, it's like, dude, I don't give a shit anymore. I'm done with this, okay? Stop nagging. I'm not saying women are naggers, but this kind of goes with reacting and fighting. Hey, if you just don't give a shit, you just don't give a shit, and it's going to catch on to him. Always be happy. This kind of shows him that, especially if you're kind of like and hesitant or upset before, if you're always happy, it shows that he's not the source of your happiness. And then he's, again, goes back down to, what is it, being mysterious and being curious. Like, why is she happy? Why is she always freaking happy? Something's up. Was independence. You know, obviously a woman who's independent is a much stronger woman, has her own shit together and things like that. Same with being mysterious, it's hard to read. You don't want to be easy to read to the guy, okay? You don't want to reveal your cards. You don't want to express all your emotions, because you do, it creates that hierarchy, and he's ahead of you. He knows where he stands. He's like, well, she's doing all this stuff, but, you know, she told me her feelings. Oh, I know she's digging me. I don't have to worry about it. She's playing that game. I'm going to play that game back, okay? So be hard to read. Next is end things first, okay? End the phone session first. End the conversation first. Be the last one to text him, right? Or let him be the last, no, sorry. Yeah, let him be the last one to text and you just don't respond. Leave him hanging and wanting more. And of course, start hiding things. Self-explanatory, you're hiding things. I wonder what that is, okay? So, with that being said, ladies, sorry I jumped through all that, but I did just, like I said, if you want more on this, I'm going to link this probably right here somewhere right now. We do some dance moves. And it's going to be a post that goes more into detail on why this works, and the link is down in the comments. And one more time, notification squad, right? I might just go like that, right? That just sounds stupid. Look, that just sounds stupid. There you go. Hey, click that notification bell if you want this video right away. I love you. Take care and peace.